Tonight on Exposing the Consumer, Windows 11 has just come out this year, bringing you closer to what you love, or does it? We take you inside the deep conspiracy theories that led to the Windows 11 hidden agenda, which explains why you need TMP and secure boot, even a new computer. It's a very dark secret in Microsoft. They recruited secret people with no idea on how life works to build their successor to the Windows 10 operating system. They turned Windows into a computerized version of their dysfunctional secret friendships, which has turned away many computer users and pissed off even more home and enterprise users. Can Windows 11 have a hidden purpose? Was Windows 11 originally going to be a performance update until new people came in and took it over? We take you inside tonight to our findings and expose the many dark truths of the new Windows 11 operating system by Microsoft. Windows 11 was a project that was developed in cooperation with Microsoft. Just 100, 300. We don't know what the hell feet it is from wherever these guys are. During Windows 11's development, there were drama erupting. What will the logo look like? How will the Windows 11 look like? How will 11 win? Ah! What will the logo look like? How will Windows 11 look like? How will Windows 11 be sold? And most importantly, where does there need to be a Windows 11?
Windows 11 had to exist because Microsoft was reforming the Windows department and they needed new people. But they know the hiring process was hard, so they sent in spies and they brainwashed a group of kids to plan the Windows 11 project.
There had to be a Windows 11 because of friends at the school. That's why they built their Windows 11 center 300 to 800 feet away from where they frequent at the school. And it's actually a scary mystery. No one's allowed inside, not even the news, not even the police. But sometimes Microsoft officials could come in and see what's going on.
The question is, how is Windows 11 actually made? Did the people who witnessed the truth, as the cult got quickly dysfunctional real fast, are they being truthful? Or is there a little more to it, to an interesting twist that we don't know? January 18th, 2018, 12:39 p.m. What was to become the Windows 11 development team was getting ready to set up the new project to succeed Windows 10 in the next 3 years. But as they were doing that, they just got a phone call from the guys at Microsoft.
Thank you for calling the Secret Life of Zach and Cody Operating Systems Project. How can we help you?
Yeah, hi, this is your 80 Microsoft Anonymous developers from China. We will be coordinating the development of what we call Windows. You guys will decide its name and its branding.
Look, we already know we're doing that. The goal is we want Windows, whatever it is, ready in the next 3 years, maybe earlier. I'd rather have it done in 2019 or whatever, but just go on. With you guys, our project will be more glitchy than ever.
Well, we want to make the next generation of Windows something a little more interesting. We do want to do a few things, and maybe you guys are way better fitted for that. Honestly, sometimes we wish we could just dig a hole from our hub in China to you guys, but we can try and work a compromise.
You see, we're actually recruiting a few more of our friends to join the cult, but I'm sure you guys have more experience over here developing things, so I think we could use some of that aid.
Yeah, so we'll start working with you guys tomorrow. In the meantime, just come up with fresh ideas for Windows. Whatever it is. Alright?
You bet. Have a nice day. Bye.
They had a phone call from Microsoft contractors in China. They were known for very controversial practices, such as rolling out buggy software, data losses, and stability issues. They could end up making the next generation of Windows terrible.
They recruited developers from China, and as a result, each Canary build was missing an opportunity to fix stability and bug issues. No one on the development team knows what Canary is, and again, Microsoft recruited inexperienced people. They thought Canary meant they could smoke something out. I don't know. We have them on security camera of them going to a McDonald's and throwing eggs at the cashier. That's what they call Canary builds, for sure.
I don't know which one it is.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yep. Good.
Good.
Oh.
Stop recording me. Now get the out of my drive-thru.
Wow.
Yeah. Record that. Record that.
I am.
What is wrong with you?
You can record me. You now just curse me out up and down.
We recording each other. Now what? What the is
going? I didn't do anything. Look at no, who love, you're talking. Dumbest.
The very next day, she did the exact same behavior at the Windows 11 Hidden Developer Center and at school. She got removed from the development team for even compiling an awful build that we will talk about shortly, and got a permanent expulsion from every school in the city.
And that is me. I'll be doing many things.
Later on, she even got fired from McDonald's and she was sent to Mars, never heard of again. I want my burgers now. And I'll see you around doing random things in the documentary. Don't miss it, stick around.
By February 2018, the first rare build of what would become Windows 11 was completed. It was actually laughable, but just as the predecessor's UI, a few changes and occasional system crashes. Although, a controversial change for sure is, taskbar was gone and replaced with something I couldn't say because the developer said I would be in prison for life if I dared to say it.
That build Windows 11 was kept secret. They were like messed up in the head with what they were thinking. The taskbar is gone and replaced with something we can't recognize, and half the entire OS is broken. You couldn't even run apps on the thing properly without the thing crashing 8 times.
On the other hand, in a divided Windows 11 development team, another person compiled a build, proving that the next OS should be more of a performance update, kind of like macOS Snow Leopard.
I feel like we should leave the fanciness until the release after. People want something that's going to be taken seriously, not crashing. I'm a kid too, but that doesn't mean I should act like them. My own compiled Windows Canary build fixed bugs and stability issues, and I think it works a lot better. I think we can add a better start menu, and I think that's about it.
But another person wanted more. You see, the thing is, another pal out here wanted to be the domination for Windows development. For purposes of this documentary, we refer to her as Jane. Jane had a few things for Windows, soon to be 11. Jane wanted to remove people she disagrees with, and cause for a complete UI overhaul. She fits the Windows 11 agenda. She also wants to give her new name and personality. Then came the year 2019. Name plans for Windows as a whole would also be planned to send over to Redmond. Various names are set out, from Jane's own name to her best friend's own name and keeping Windows. Version names were set out from Windows 10, Windows 10, Who the Hell Cares Edition, Windows Toilet, Windows Jane, Windows 8, Windows Me, and Windows 11. Out of all those choices, Jane kept the Windows name and chose the Windows 11 name, and she had to design a new logo.
We designed the Windows 11 logo in 2 seconds. We were told not to have an argument. You know Jane's ego, she's an interesting person you'll meet. She may have a bad temper, but that's okay. We were scratching our heads for a new Windows logo. We asked to keep the old one. But in the end, we just looked at a window from our classroom and said, hey, this can be Windows 11's logo. I had a class with Jane at the time, so it was easy for her to reach and she was like, yes, so we cheated on our math exams.
But no one knew about Windows 11 logo until 2.5 years later, when a deadly virus was still spreading around the world, and when the vaccines were rolling out. We'll talk more on that later. But Windows 11 development under Jane was getting underway. No one here would care about making it stable to use. Just designing, arguing, and coding. It would be the most interesting but stupid decision done to someone, just like when Harry Styles urged a recent college grad to quit her job. Speaking about college grads, the development team of the Windows 11 agenda faced hidden controversy for turning away smart people. Would have made Windows 11 better and more stable than its predecessor. We talked more of them to see what's going on.
So I heard there was an opening on the Windows website for Windows redesign, Windows engineering, whatever that is, in 2019, and I called them. Windows then transferred me to some high school chimpanzees, and Jane picked up the phone. She told me to go F myself. But guess what? Because they didn't hire me? Because there was drama on here since they didn't hire me? Because there was drama on here since Windows Longhorn's development, and they didn't reset development like Longhorn? They shipped a f***ing broken product. So guess what? The entire Windows 11 development team can go f*** themselves. Look, they released a broken product filled with their teenage drama, and they're selling it to consumers at Best Buy. Look at it. Who wants to use this thing? It's broken. And now there needs to be more updates than usual to make it actually run better.
Can you guys please be quiet here? You've glitched out an operating system. I'm trying to get some sleep. And keep it vivid warm.